come, yep. Here we come. I am happy to be here. Pants. Tie. And then I took my dad's belt and it didn't even fit me.
Good morning, Trojans. Today's date is Thursday, January 11th, and it's a B-Day. I'm Isabella Holsten.
And I'm Luca Palermo. Today's quote is from Barack Obama, who was the first African-American president of the United States. He helped oversee the recovery of the Great Recession of 2008. He had this to say, quote, "Change will not come if we wait for some other person or some other time. We are the ones we've been waiting for. We are the change we seek," unquote.
On this day in history, in 1935, Amelia Earhart performed a solo flight from Hawaii to the mainland of the United States. She was the first person in history to achieve this feat. Her journey took her from Honolulu to Oakland, California.
Well, sometimes I go out by myself and I look across the water. And I think of all the things what you're doing, and in my head I paint a picture.
There will be an informational swim meeting in D1 at lunch today. You can chat with the coaches and hear how to get ready for the upcoming swim season. Anyone interested in being on the team is welcome. All levels are welcome. Go check it out.
Interested in starting a new club this semester? There will be a club president's meeting at lunch in D1 tomorrow where you can learn how to start a club and reserve a table for Spring Club Rush.
If you already have an existing club, you can also reserve a table for the Spring Club Rush.
Tomorrow is the last day to try the Guests of December holiday for the display in the library, or by scanning the QR code.
Guess the holidays and see how many you know. The top three scores will win a prize, and the student with the highest score will have their name posted with permission.
Our Trojan Cheer team is heading to the Cheer National Competition. If you know someone from Trojan Cheer, be sure to wish them luck.
You can also send them off in style by cheering them on during their cheer showcase this Saturday in San Rafael. It's at 10:30 a.m. at the Terra Linda High School gym.
Do you enjoy the outdoors? Do you like interacting and socializing with kids? If that sounds like you, then plan on going to the initial counselor meeting for the 6th grade camp outdoor education at the Sonoma Mountain Elementary School multi-use room next week on Wednesday, January 17th at 7 p.m.
This outdoor education serves Miwok, Old Adobe, La Tercera, Loma Vista, Sonoma Mountain, and Pengrove schools. If you have any questions before the meeting or are unable to make it that night but are still interested in learning more about becoming a camp counselor, please email adobecamp6@gmail.com.
Have you visited the Petaluma Wildlife Museum on campus? You can meet Suki, the African bullfrog.
What's up, dude? It's time to eat. Yes.
This is Suki, our African pixie frog here at the Petaluma Wildlife Museum.
This is our African pixie frog, scientific name, Pixicephalus adspersus. This one's named Suki. Suki is one of our animal ambassadors here at the Petaluma Wildlife Museum, and she is a great learning tool that we use to educate and get people interested in conservation. African pixie frogs dwell in grass and shrub lands of sub-Saharan Africa in countries like Angola, Botswana, and Kenya, to name a few. They spend most of their time submerged underground to escape the hot sun.
These frogs are a very unique species that have many adaptations that most frogs don't. They're one of only three frog species known to have teeth that they use to hunt their prey, mainly being reptiles, small mammals, and birds. They're also a cannibalistic species, so they eat other African pixie frogs as well. African pixie frogs can live up to 25 years, which is an extremely long lifespan for amphibians. The exact population of this species is not super well known because they cover a large amount of land across multiple countries. They are currently listed as least concern on the IUCN Endangered Species List. However, This doesn't mean their population isn't decreasing. It is assumed that it is decreasing in South Africa due to habitat loss.
These frogs exhibit something called sexual dimorphism. The males of the species are about twice the size of the females. Males tend to weigh 3 to 4 pounds, while females are only about 1 to 2 pounds, but this still makes these frogs the second largest species in the entire world. These guys can reproduce pretty rapidly, and females can tend to lay 3,000 to 4,000 eggs per cluster and lay 20 to 30 clusters per breeding season. But after these females lay the eggs, she leaves and has the male guard and protect the tadpoles from possible predators. But interestingly enough, not all predators. Due to the fact that these thousands and thousands of tadpoles completely inundate a local ecosystem, male pixie frogs have adapted to be cannibalistic, eating a few of the tadpoles he protects simply due to the overwhelming population. You can visit Suki and learn more about African pixie frogs at our open house events every Saturday from 11 to 3 at the Petaluma Wildlife Museum.
Here are today's club meetings.
Circle of Friends meets in the Butterfly Garden today. You can contact Hope Carver at hcarver24@pekka12.org if you want to learn more about them.
The Environmental Club meets in F13. Contact Maya Skolnick at mskolnick24@pekka12.org if you want to be a friend of our planet.
The Knitting and Crocheting Club meets in C3. You can contact Annabelle Waitrick-Trum at awaitricktrum26@pekka12.org if you want to learn more.
Ping Pong meets in F6. Come down for some light exercise and friendly competition with all-around good time of a game. All skill levels are welcome.
Smash Club meets in Mr. Langerman Toe's room, which is the portable right outside the main doors heading to the parking lot.
The Future Women Leaders of Business and Industry meets today in A4. Contact Sunny Schultz or Kenley Eskes at sschultz24@pekka12.org or kskes24@pekka12.org.
The Engineering and Robotics Club meets every Thursday after school in F17. Totally beginner-friendly. Contact Leody White for any questions at lwhite24@pekka12.org.
The Volleyball Club meets today in the gym. You can contact Adrian Cortez at acortezgalena25@pekka12.org if you have any questions.
That's it for today's program. Stay safe out there, Trojans, and make it a great day! Let's go! We did it!
I'm leaving.